All right, everybody ready?
Good.
Good morning. In a few hours, we're going to be in the midst of our second major snowstorm in less than a week. This one has the potential to be quite serious, and certainly we know that it's going to dump someplace in the neighborhood of 10 or more inches on Kansas City. So this morning at 9 o'clock a.m., we declared a state of emergency for Kansas City, Missouri. We began towing vehicles that posed a public safety hazard. We tried our very best to give as much notice of that potentiality yesterday as possible, but unfortunately the time is up, the storm is getting nearer, and we have to do what is necessary to make sure that our emergency vehicles and our first responders have access to homes and apartments so that they can get in to do their jobs when needed. The declaration is going to continue until 11:59 Wednesday night, which is 1 minute before midnight, which would then turn into Thursday. And as it did last week, this declaration allows the city to keep crews on, add additional personnel to battle the storm, waive administrative and budget routine requirements, and collective bargaining agreements so that we are able to meet public safety and transportation needs without undue delay, and so that we can respond to the needs of the city and to the citizens in it. Essentially, we're calling in everyone that we can who can help. Frankly, they've already been called on. They haven't really left since last week. And I hope that the residents of the city were able to see a difference. Obviously, we weren't able to be everywhere at once, but we were as many places as we could possibly be under the circumstances. And our crews have really been working their tails off to make this as safe of a situation as possible and get to as many city residents as possible. They've worked extremely long shifts day after day, and they're continuing. I'm really proud of them for the work that they've done, and the fact that they've been out working in the cold weather for extended periods of time for days now. The cleanup that we're engaged in now has become even more urgent because of the impending storm, and we need the help of our citizens in order to make this run as smoothly as possible. We absolutely would appreciate it if you could stay off the roads, stay home tomorrow if you possibly can, keep your vehicles on the right side of the street. If you park on a street that runs north and south, then please park on the west side of the street. If there is a no parking sign, forget it, ignore it, it doesn't matter during this time of emergency. Mm-hmm. If you park on a street that runs east and west, park on the north side of the street. And the reason for this is very obvious. With the size of the snow plows and the narrowness of the street, if we got cars parked on both sides, it's either difficult or impossible to get the plows down to help plow you out. If you can, park in your driveway and off the street. If you can't, please remember the way that you should park and spread the word to your friends and neighbors. You know, don't hesitate to make sure that they know, because it will inure to your benefit if everybody is following that rule and parking on the same side of the street. We'll be keeping community centers and shelters open. There'll be crews on the roads, and emergency personnel are on alert and doing their jobs. We'll do our part, but we need our Kansas City citizens to take this seriously and to spread the word and to be off the roads as much as possible. Our police and fire personnel need to make runs and to do things, and the easier it is for them to get to where they need to go, the better and the more efficient they're going to be about performing their duties and helping people in need. So please check on your elderly neighbors. That would be a good thing. Check on your neighbors regardless of age. Stick together. Make sure that the little ones aren't out long when they're out playing and sledding and doing those things. Let's continue our hashtag LoveKC program on Twitter, where we try to identify Kansas Cityans that are going above and beyond and out of their way to help others, so that we can highlight the good works of people in Kansas City and thereby encourage others to do the same.